Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. In this video, I'm talking about the empirical rule. An empirical rule tells us what percentage of the data falls within the different standard deviations. So if you have a distribution that is roughly bell-shaped, as you can see over here on the right, we would say that 68% of all the values in that data set fall within one standard deviation of the mean. So if our mean is in the center, then one standard deviation to the right is 34.1% of the data values, and to the left are 34.1% of the data values, which makes a total of 68.2% of the data values falling between one deviation to the left and one deviation to the right. Then if we go out another standard deviation, we can see that another 13.6% of our data falls within that standard deviation. And to the left, from one standard deviation back to two, is another 13.6% of the data. And if you add together the yellow and the green, then you get 95.4% of the data values. So that most of the time, when we look at data that's roughly distributed, symmetrically distributed, we see that 95% of the data values lie within two standard deviations of the mean. And so when we talk about unusual values, we talk about values that are outside of that percentage, right? So if it's of those standard deviations. So if it's outside of two standard deviations, we start to say it's unusual. Even if you look at the next standard deviation out, we add another 2.1% to that total, and 2.1% from the other end as well, and that gives us 99.7% of our data values, which means out here in the tail we have an additional few data values that are outside three standard deviations. If you had something that said, oh, this is six standard deviations away from the mean, then you're a crazy outlier, right? You're way outside that normal range of 99.7%. So when we talk about range of usual values, we're talking about two standard deviations below up until two standard deviations above. And anything out that is not considered to be part of our usual values. So the kind of questions you might be asked is like this one. Find the range of usual values for a sample set of data involving the ages of students entering a local university. The mean and standard deviation are given below. Would a student entering the college at age 25 be considered unusual? Well, if our mean is 18 and our standard deviation is 3, to find the minimum value, we take 18 minus 2 times the standard deviation. Because remember, we could go left or right with that standard deviation. 2 times 3 is 6, and 18 minus 6 would be 12. And on the other hand, a maximum value would be 18 plus 2 times 3. Again, it's 6, but this time we're adding it on. So we have the mean value plus 6, and that gives us 24. And that tells us that 95% of the students entering into that university are between the ages of 12 and 24. 12 seems pretty low, but anyways, would a student entering the college at age 25 be considered unusual? Well, in this case, they would be, because up till 24 is in our usual range of values. Anything above 24 or below 12 would be considered an unusual. Since the age of the student in question is more than two standard deviations above the mean, they would be considered an unusual age coming into that college. So to find the range of usual values, you find 2 times the standard deviation, subtract that from the mean, and add that to the mean, and that's going to give you those acceptable ranges. And remember that the acceptable ranges mean 2 down and 2 up means 95% or 95.4% of those values are going to fall within that range. And everything outside of that is what we could start to consider unusual. All right, have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.